Thank you, Ian. My name is Logan. Today I'm going to present my work, Minimise the Diaphragm Forming Defect by Reduce the Interply Slip Resistance. So diaphragm forming is a composite preforming technique. Basically use a vacuum and a diaphragm to deform a flat lamina into a desired preformed geometry. And because it uses 2D laminates, so that means the layup speed and layup can be more faster and easier in compared with the ply by ply layup on tool surface. And it's also a cost efficient method to manufacture large composite components such as the aircraft wing spars or stiffeners. But there's a limit. This method is only suitable for making simple geometric. Why? Let's have a look in ideal forming situation. Imagine you bend a book. Each page will slide from its neighbor a little bit and form this nice corner region. But you can't really do the same thing with prepreg stack because there's a resin at the ply interface which will prevent this slip happen. So if you bend it, it will develop the interply shear stress, which will compress the inner plies and form wrinkles. That's a defect you don't want. And if you want to make a more complicated geometry, you need both in-plane and out-plane shear during the forming. It makes this wrinkling mechanism more complicated. So if we can minimize this defect generation, that means we can improve the production rate in different applications. How can we do it? In conventional method, increase the forming temperature. That means you reduce the resin thickness, promote ply slip. Also use lower forming speed. That means you give some time to relax the shear stress caused by resin viscoelasticity. But you need heating temperature. If it's a big part, you need a lot of energy. And also the process time is still long. And also the conventional method doesn't really solve the wrinkling problem when you make more complicated geometry. So in our work, we propose a different method we call lubrication method. By interleaving additional material at the ply interface, it promotes the ply slip during forming. And we also select the materials already being used for toughening or resin modification. So in principle, they can improve the mechanical performance of cured composite parts. We made an interply slip test. So basically, you make a prepreg sandwich, hold the other two, and pull the center one, see how much force we need to make a ply slip. And we have a single diaphragm forming rig to the actual forming. By using a rectangular mold with slight cutout region at the middle, here, so it can give the laminate both in-plane and out-plane shear during forming. So let's have a look. The material we use is a standard carbon fiber prepreg. And in this case, we use a polyester veil as a lubricant. Because we can control the testing temperature and the pressure, so we can simulate the condition in actual layup and the forming. This is the result, the slip test result. As you can see, if we add the lubricant, it significantly reduced the interply slip resistance, both at low temperature and high temperature compared with the normal. So that means we can manipulate with the resistance in different conditions. And this is the interesting part. We made a forming test, use a quasi-isotropic symmetric layup. Here, this one, we form at a 6 degree without any additional material. You can see both from the inside or outside of the arrow shape, there are some wrinkles developed around the corner because the compression and tension, implant compression and tension. But when we apply the veils, you can see the forming quality is significantly improved, even using lower forming temperature. So conclusion, we demonstrate this method can reduce the interply slip resistance, which can give us better forming quality, even at low temperatures, which means you can achieve a higher energy efficiency and also improve the production rate. Also, we have shown this method has the potential to improve the forming quality of a more complicated composite geometric. So in the future, we are trying to investigate how this method will affect the mechanical, I mean, the structural performance of the cured parts. And also, we are trying to manufacture a component using the material manufactured by automation layup process. So I have to thank you, the technical fiber product provides us the materials. And thank you for your attention.